such an incredible genre. It's the only genre of movie I'm interested in making.
Lin, it's so great to speak to you about In the Heights. I have been so excited for this film for way too long. And I'm so glad.
All of us. Imagine how I feel.
I was going to say, I'm just a viewer. I can't imagine how it feels as the person like behind it. First of all, this has had just like the most incredible history. You started writing this when you were in college, right? And then now it's one of the most anticipated blockbusters of 2021. How do you process that lifespan for this show?
I think, again, it's almost indistinguishable from my own career and journey and trajectory. And I'll be processing the In the Heights movie for years. You know, it's one thing to write a love letter to your neighborhood where you still live. And where you married the person who also lived in that neighborhood. It's another thing to then film those songs on location in the places they're about. So, you know, I watched that movie and it's not just a movie to me. That's the corner of 175th Street. That's where we went swimming when I was a little boy. That's, you know, the scene where Nina and Benny are singing Where You're Home, that's in J. Hood Wright Park. I would walk through that park to take my son to pre-K. My wife's first apartment without roommates was across the street from that park. Her father grew up in a building that you can see in the movie. So again, there's layers to the show. And I can tell you where I was when I was writing every song in that thing. In fact, I do in this In the Heights book that's coming out on the 15th. But then there's also just the layers of, you know, of being in a neighborhood and staying there and then getting to see this love letter to it.
Your entire DNA is in this film now. That's just going to be out there forever. That is crazy.
Yeah, I mean, my parents are in the song Breathe. Like, they pop up and sing Welcome Home. Like, my wife is in the last shot. She's in the crowd singing around the hydrants with my father-in-law. So it's really a family affair.
It's perfect. I loved every second of it as well. It just made me feel so warm, and I was so happy to see it on screen finally. It does sort of feel like we are in this big renaissance of, like, the musical film. I feel like we're getting a lot more, there's a lot more, like, I don't know, but just it feels like people are backing those stories now.
Yeah, and again, I grew up I'm an 80s kid. I was told by the internet that I am a geriatric millennial. that's apparently my bracket. Honestly, I'm fine with it. It's cool, whatever you want to call me, I'm cool with it. But I grew up in an era where there were almost no movie musicals, to the point where you could actually name them because there were so few of them. It was Fame. It was Newsies, which I saw opening weekend, and like very, very few. So I really grew up with my parents' old musicals. I grew up watching Sound of Music and The Unsinkable Molly Brown and The Bandwagon and you know, all of the Astaire classics. But we didn't have Labyrinth. Labyrinth was another big one from the 80s. But there are so many. What I'm so excited about with the wave that are coming out this year is they couldn't be more different. You'd never confuse your Evan Hansen with In the Heights. You'd never confuse Everybody's Talking About Jamie with Tick, Tick, Boom. And I think as long as we can keep up that diversity, I think Hollywood will keep taking chances on it, because it's such an incredible genre. It's the only genre of movie I'm interested in making. And so I'm thrilled that we're in a kind of golden era.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like, if you think you don't like musicals, like, you're wrong, because there's so many different types that will...
There's one out there for you, I promise.
Absolutely. Oh, sorry, my cat is in the background. Thank you so much, and congratulations on In the Heights. I am excited to be able to watch this, like, whenever I want now, because it was just...
Thank you very much. I can't wait for you to see it.